back at 6:24. Here's a question for you. What would you do if someone collapsed and had a heart attack right in front of you? Diane Atwood, who writes the blog Catching Health, is here to walk us through some steps that could actually save a person's life.
They have saved people's lives. Yes. Well, let's begin with Joe Gould's story. 8 years ago, he had a heart attack while he was working out at his local YMCA, and he nearly died. He survived because the people around him reacted quickly, and also because there was an automated external defibrillator, or AED, nearby. So first, someone called 911. Then someone else started doing CPR on him, hands-only CPR. You don't have to do mouth-to-mouth. Just push hard and fast in the center of the chest to the beat of the disco song, Staying Alive. If there isn't an AED available, keep doing CPR until help arrives. Now, if there is an AED nearby, in a perfect world, you or someone else will have had AED training. Don't be intimidated if you haven't. Take a deep breath. They're designed for non-medical people. A recorded voice, you might hear it in the video that we're showing in the background, a recorded voice will guide you through every single step, telling you exactly what to do. Now, we have the complete video demonstration that you can watch that will show you how to do hands-only CPR and use an AED. It is a version of what you're seeing now. You'll find it on the station's website and also on my Catching Health blog later this morning. And also, MCD Public Health here in Maine and the Maine Cardiovascular Health Council won a grant to buy and place hundreds of AEDs in rural Maine communities. I'm going to tell you more about that project and where to apply for your community on my blog. You just go to catchinghealth.com. Now, finally, Joe, who's only 52, by the way, wants you to know that 8 years have passed since his heart attack and he's doing great. He had 3 stents put in, and then a few months later, he and his wife did the trek across Maine. She wouldn't let him go by himself, though. She had to be right there by his side. Now, ever since, he's been trying to stay healthy and also to spread the word about AEDs. Interestingly enough, doctors discovered when he was in the hospital for his heart that he had a very rare bone cancer. They found it in its earliest stages.
And only because of his heart attack.
Only because of his heart attack, because they had to do different kinds of tests on him.
There are blessings in disguise everywhere around us.
So the AED saved his life twice, he says.
Excellent, excellent. And watching that video, I can see how it would be very, you know, it would be very easy to start panicking in a situation like that. It's just really important to stay calm and take your time and just get it done.
Right? Absolutely. Yeah. That's why you've got to take that deep breath.
Deep breath.
You can do it. You can do it. I promise.
All right. Thanks, Diane, very much. And that's going to wrap up this half hour, but we've got one more to go, so stay right there. We'll be right back.